So in 1909, Ford Motor Company had the first year of production of the Model T. They built 10,000 cars that year. Those cars sold for about $850. In 1909, $850 was a lot of money. That was more than what most people made in a year. But Henry Ford continued to invest in the company so that he could make cars quicker and faster and less expensive. He created and opened his own engineering school, which didn't exist anywhere in the country at that time. He grew his own engineers. He grew his own rubber trees to make tires. He had his own steel mill in the factory that took iron ore and made frames and body parts. And by investing in all of that, he was able to drive costs down and control the quality to the point where 17 years later in 1926, they weren't making 10,000 cars a year. They were making 10,000 cars a day. And the price of the car had gone down from $850 to $260. And that allowed a whole new class of people to own cars than what was previously possible. What I like about the Henry Ford story is it shows that if you go vertical with your supply chain, by doing our own design work, by sourcing our own foundries and Ford shops, and by doing our machining inside, we're able to buy blocks a lot cheaper than we can buy blocks on the outside. We're able to buy cylinder heads cheaper than we can buy cylinder heads on the outside, and we can control the quality. But the net result is we're able to make engines less expensive than anybody else can, and we share that savings with our customers, so we sell more engines. The more engines we sell, the more we make. The more we make, the more we can invest. And we're going to continue to make that investment and control our destiny and provide our customers with a really high-value product.